If I could go back and relive this experience, would I do it differently? Yes. Did I make a mistake that I regret? I'm gonna go with no. You know, these kind of things just have a way of working themselves out. What is up, old souls? This is Reed from Everyman Vintage, and I'm super stoked to have you along today on my little walk down memory lane. Now, I know I previously said in a video that my Martin D18 from 1955 was the one that started it all. And I will stand by that statement because it did really start something for me. It started something that was intentional, something that I knew what I was doing. I knew what I was getting into, and I knew where I was going. Today, however, is my first ever vintage guitar. The reason I say this is different is because I had no clue what I was doing. I was 16. I just saw this cool guitar hanging on the wall and thought I need to have that. And so that's how I came upon this 1965 Gibson Hummingbird. Now, with as most of the guitars I feature on this channel, it has some issues. That's the everyman part of vintage. It's something that every man can afford, including an idiot 16-year-old. And so here's how I came to get the guitar. Every Saturday, my mom would go to the grocery store, and I would ride along with her because across the street was a local music store. I would basically have her drop me off at the music store. She'd go across the street, shop for groceries, and come back and pick me up. Thinking back, I'm not sure the music store really loved having me there every Saturday, but, you know, that's what kids do when they're obsessed with something. And they can't complain too much because I did buy several guitars from them. I got my first ever really good guitar from them. It was an American Standard Fender Stratocaster. But over time, my interests shift to more acoustic music, and that brings us to this guitar. So I walk in one Saturday, and there's this cherry sunburst Gibson Hummingbird guitar sitting there. And I saw that it was from 1965. Now, I'd read, you know, Guitar World and blah, blah, blah. And I knew that vintage guitars were a thing, but I just knew this was an old guitar, and I thought it sounded really good, and I had to have it. Obviously, I didn't have the money to buy it, but I still had to have it. And so what I did was I stuck the guitar in layaway. I had a few $100s. I put that down as a deposit, and I put the guitar in layaway. Now, you got a year to get it out in that kind of situation, but I didn't think I'd have too much time making up the rest of the money. Now, did I mention that this music store was a cool music store? They would let me come in every Saturday. They would get the guitar out of the back for me, let me play it graciously. I'd play it, give it back, and then I would come back the next week. So they knew I had a passion for this guitar, and they knew I would eventually get it out. They were so cool about things, however, that when my sister was getting married and she had asked me to play in her wedding, they even let me take the guitar out of layaway, take it to her wedding, play it, and they knew that I'd bring it back the next week, which I did. And eventually I did get it out of layaway, but it wasn't as easy as I had thought. I was about $600 short a few months before my year was up in layaway. So I did what I had to do. I knew Wendy's was looking for somebody to flip burgers, and I needed the money. So I applied to Wendy's, got a job. I calculated 2 weeks before I'd be able to pay the guitar off, and that's when I put in my 2 weeks notice. I was on a mission, and I was getting ready to accomplish it. So I put in my 2 weeks notice, work those 2 weeks, get my pay, and I go and I get the guitar out of layaway. And the rest is, shall we say, history. Now, a little bit about Gibson Hummingbirds. They were introduced by Gibson in 1960, and at the time, they were the second most expensive guitar in Gibson's line. So for the first couple of years, it was the second most expensive guitar they made, then they introduced the Dove, and it became the third. However, the Hummingbird is such a cool guitar. It is a mahogany guitar, mahogany back and sides, spruce top, mahogany neck. It's got a Brazilian rosewood bridge, ebony fingerboard with split parallelogram inlays. It's got gold tuners. It's just a really cool guitar. Now, the guitar had issues, as I mentioned before. I was told that they got it from the widow of a gentleman who played it in church all the time, which I can totally see. It had a heel crack, which was stable, but the guy had like either painted or put a decal of some like leafy vine kind of going across to disguise the repair work that had been done, and it's still there. It's never moved. It looks the same, but that did help me to be able to attain this guitar at such a young age. I'm not sure the bridge is original either, but either way, I said I didn't know what I was doing. I just thought it was a cool guitar, so I bought it. All right, and again, this was before I had transitioned into more of a bluegrass player. I hadn't yet discovered Tony Rice, and so it definitely has a different tone that doesn't fit that mold. And as such, It didn't get played a lot for a lot of years. It was my main guitar for a while, and if you've been following the channel, I had the Hummingbird, then I had a custom guitar built for me, all right, which I did a video on not too long ago. And then I bought the D18, and that was kind of the progression of things. So this is the one that started it off. Now, as a Gibson guitar, I think it has a very different tone than a bluegrass guitar or a Martin guitar would have. So it does occupy an interesting space in my kind of guitar arsenal, if you will. I think that it's a little heavier built, being built in the 60s than it previously was. Perhaps the finish is a little thicker. Pick guard is this big thick thing sitting on top of it. And it doesn't have as much focused, clear, to the point kind of a sound like many Martins do. It definitely has a warm, soft edge to it, and it blends really well and is an amazing rhythm guitar. So as I demo this guitar, I was very conscious of my pick choice to kind of match the guitar, to bring out of it what I'm looking for. I obviously subconsciously do that as I'm playing as well. The guitar is now seeing a lot more use. I have a pickup in that guitar. I've got a Nellar Bags Lyric pickup that I think sounds really, really good, and I use the guitar when I play out in like a rock and roll kind of a setting, more so than I do in an acoustic setting. It just doesn't project in the same way that a Martin does, but it does have a really sweet and a really great tone that I want to share with you now. So I'm going to strum the guitar a little bit, kind of where I think the guitar lives really well, kind of brushy, sitting in the mix kind of a thing. And then I'm also going to play more single string, flat picking type stuff, maybe a fiddle tune, which is kind of where I live lots of times, just so you can hear it in a different context. I want you to be able to hear the guitar a couple of different ways. And so here you go, my 1965 Gibson Hummingbird. Well, there you have it, Old Souls, 1965 Gibson Hummingbird. I hope you've enjoyed this video and you enjoyed hearing that guitar as well as its story, because really to me, that's what this whole thing is all about. And so I would love it if you'd like and subscribe to the channel. What I'd really like more than anything though is to get you to comment and tell me your story that is similar to the one that I just shared. Do you have a music store that was cool and gracious like the one I described? Do you have your first foray into vintage guitars? Did you ever buy a guitar that when you look back on it, you realize how little you actually knew about that kind of thing, yet it worked out well in the end? Did you ever throw a guitar in layaway and have to get it out within a year? Did you have to work some job to pay it off? I guess that's why this guitar is special to me. You know, it was my first vintage guitar, but I also had to work a very specific job to get it, and it was just the feeling that I got when I finally paid that sucker off, it was like no other. And the guitar has been my companion in some way ever since. And so if you like this, please comment, please share your story, and subscribe to my channel, because I've got lots of cool stuff in the works and I can't wait to share it with you. So until next time, I am Reed from Everyman Vintage. We'll see you later.